Rick with Tools for Boards here today to show you how to use liquid wax. So liquid is an alternative to using a solid or a block of wax, and there's certain advantages with liquid. The main advantage is coverage. So you get better coverage with a liquid than you do with a solid. In order to get the same amount of coverage with a solid, you have to reheat the material into the base a number of times. With liquid, you only have to apply it once and you get almost absolute coverage. So I'll show you today how to use liquid wax. We have Brico Mafluz base wax. So this is soft base and medium base. The soft base is used as a saturation material. The medium is a harder paraffin dissolved in a solvent so that it hardens the base after you've applied the soft. We also have a range of temperature-specific waxes. So this is warm, BP1, yellow, medium, which is red, and cold, which is a harder paraffin, that is blue. We also have low fluoro and high fluoro versions of liquid. They're in a very easy to use format, and the system is very very simple. So there's three different wax of the day that you have to choose from. Choose the temperature specific wax, snow temp specific, not ambient temperature. So it's the temperature of the snow that we're after. So in order to use the wax, what I'll do is I'll take, in this case, soft base. I'll shake it thoroughly, okay? It's paraffin dissolved in a solvent, and you want to make sure that you use liquid wax in a well-ventilated area, okay? Remove the cap. I'll pour a small quantity in a cup or a mug. It's a very small quantity. Liquid wax is far more efficient than solid, so you use far less material. After I've poured it, I'll make sure that I put the cap back on so that the solvent in the remaining wax doesn't evaporate. And then I'll take the cup or the mug. This is a ceramic mug or a glass with a paintbrush. Sorry, not a toothbrush. This is a 1-inch paintbrush, either a horsehair or nylon bristle brush will be fine. You can get them at your local hardware store. Dip it in the liquid, okay? And then I'm going to be applying liquid to a clean ski, so it's been cleaned with Brico Mafluz clean detergent. Okay, we have earlier videos that show how to clean the base that you can refer to. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply it in about 15 to 20 centimeter increments down the length of the base, and then immediately cork the wax, rubbing and pressing. Okay. And this will give it more penetration, better penetration into the base. Okay, so I'm going to do that. And I'm actually spreading some of the residual wax further down the base. Okay, just make sure that there's an even coat across the base. All right, and then I'll repeat the process with the paintbrush again. Another 15 or 20 centimeters. Liquid is ideal because you apply very little wax, so it's not necessary to have a lot of wax dripped on the ski that would happen with a solid. And then with a solid, you end up scraping most of the wax onto the floor. That's not the case with a liquid. It's a very efficient means of applying wax, and as mentioned, you get far better coverage. So, I'll do this again, just to finish the ski. Okay, and then immediately rub and press using a cork. Okay, that will really get the wax into the amorphous part of the base. So there's two structures in the base. There's a crystalline structure and an amorphous structure. Wax doesn't penetrate the crystalline structure, but it penetrates the amorphous part of the base. So when a base is produced, it's produced under heat and pressure in a cylinder, and that cylinder is skived or it's peeled. You end up with a base material. Where it's peeled, you basically have gaps and valleys in no particular order, okay? And there's a crystalline portion. Around the crystalline structure, there's voids or spaces, gaps. And what effectively what you're trying to do when you're waxing is you're trying to press, push, using mechanical means to make the wax stick in those voids for as long as possible. Okay, and the nature of snow, the crystalline structure, the abrasive nature of snow is trying to tear the wax out. You get a maximum of 15 microns of penetration of wax into the base, okay, when you wax. So that's the width of a human hair. So the base isn't a sponge. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to keep the wax in the base for as long as possible. So that's a bit of background on the actual base material. Okay, so I've finished corking. I'm going to let the ski stand for about 10 to 15 minutes in order for the wax to harden. Okay, and then I've already done that actually with the other ski. So I'll put this in our vise. This is our fixed symmetrical vise, which is a great vise for holding all skis, okay, and it clamps on center, which is very stable, and it doesn't matter how wide your tip or tail on the ski is, it's not going to fall off the end supports because it always clamps on center. So we have here a ski that the wax has been applied, the liquid wax. It's had enough time to harden, okay? For added durability, you can use an iron and a sheet of Teflon. So you have to make a decision. For recreational skiing, you can stop here. There's no need to scrape, which is a huge advantage. And because you're using a liquid, you're not scraping, you're not damaging the structure of the ski in any way. Even with a sharp scraper, if you're scraping the base, you're actually causing some damage to the structure of the ski. With liquid, that's not the case. So I can stop here and I can just proceed to brush out the base and I'm done. Or if I want optimal penetration of the wax, the liquid wax into the base, what I'll do is I'll use a sheet of Teflon with an iron. So with soft base, the iron temperature is about 130 degrees Celsius, okay? And I'll apply the wax using the iron with the sheet of Teflon between the sole plate of the iron and the base, okay? I'm drawing this down the length of the ski. Each pass should be about 8 seconds for a typical adult length ski. And I'm going to make a pass here, okay? And then I'll go back to the beginning. And I'll draw the ski, the iron again down the base. The Teflon allows the iron to glide very well. Because there's such a thin layer of wax on the base, if you don't have a sheet of Teflon, you may have the sole plate of the iron contacting the base edge of the ski, so you want to avoid grinding. And also the Teflon acts as a buffer, so there's an indirect heat transfer to the base. It's not as direct as it would be if you weren't using Teflon, and that minimizes the potential to damage the ski. So the appearance of the wax when you iron it in is a chalky appearance. It's not a pooling effect that you get with a solid, because you're applying a lot of excess wax with a solid. So this is a chalky appearance. That's normal. After you finish ironing, once you brush the base, you'll get a deep sheen, the same as you would with a solid. So again, a huge advantage to liquid is you use very little wax, only the wax that's required to penetrate the base. And you're not scraping the majority of the wax onto the floor after you finish waxing. So I'm going to make one more pass here, okay? And then I've effectively used an iron with Teflon sheet in order to maximize the penetration. So you get the same penetration as a solid with an iron, but you get far better coverage. With a solid, you'd have to reheat the material, the solid wax, into the base a number of times to get the same coverage. and you may not get the same coverage because with a liquid you get almost absolute coverage the first time you apply it. So now, instead of scraping, I'm just going to run over the base with my series of brushes. I have Tools for Boards Buff. This is a brass brush. This is the first brush after waxing, so I'll go direct to the brush, okay? And as you can see, there's very little material that's being brushed off the base, residual wax. Effectively, almost all the wax that I've applied to the base is in the base. So, make a few more passes with the brass brush. And this reopens the base structure, so it takes all the residual wax out of the grooves in the base, okay, to expose the linear pattern. And as I mentioned in earlier videos, the linear pattern, the purpose of the linear pattern is to reduce suction, the suction effect. So I'm finished with the brass brush. Now with the hard horsehair, okay, I'll make a few passes. This brush will help sweep away all the excess wax that was brushed up with the brass brush. Okay, and then finally, I'll finish with a soft nylon. And this brush is used as a final brush to buff out the base, to polish and buff the wax. So if you look at the base now, the sheen is apparent. You get the same result that you would with a solid, but it's far simpler, far less waste, and a lot easier. So for more information on liquid wax or to purchase, go to toolsforboards.com.